note.
So I just realized that it is really hard to become a self-made YouTuber or a content creator, because I just realized when I made this whole video and I put it on the computer, and when I edit it, it really is sucked. My eyes were all over the place and I don't even see the camera, and it feels like I'm talking to myself, and yet it is hard because I am here talking to myself. There is no housemate because my housemate is now, I don't know where she is. She's on a date, I guess. And here I am alone with only the camera in front of me and trying to talk about the YouTube algorithm, which I didn't really understand quite well, but I just love it. Have you ever feel like you are being watched by some sort of agent or agency who's continuously stalking at you? Because I kind of feel like I am being stalked and watched when I'm online. Why? Because just a couple days ago, I think I have a second thought that I want to buy a things, like I want to buy a boot. There are so many advertisements popping up at my account, like my Instagram or Facebook or name any platform, like it continuously pops up on my social account. So I guess we are being watched, right? And I don't know if there is some people or a data. I don't know if those people seeing my last search on my search engine, or maybe there's some sort of an artificial intelligence data that can know what you're looking for. Or even if I only have a second thought in my mind, somehow the things that what's on my mind pop up on my screen. Like, it's really crazy. Somehow I kind of thank the algorithm, especially the YouTube algorithm. Why? Because for the past years I've been searching for an inspiration or a YouTuber or a content creator or a filmmaker that I can follow or that can be my muse. I've been searching for any type of vlogs, and I feel like they know what I want. They know what I really need. They know what I've been searching for, because I just found out a couple channels that is useful for me and could be my inspiration in making this video or this journal. So yeah, the reason why I'm looking for an inspiration, because first, I love making movie and I really love photography, but I don't really love being in front of the camera. But here I am, now I'm being in front of the camera. So the second one, I love vlogging, like I love capturing everything, like my daily life. But who am I? I'm not a superstar. Like, who wants to watch this ordinary girl who works at a company and yeah, just ordinary people? But I really love making it. I love making the craft. I love the whole process of editing. I just love it, and at the same time I want to make it interesting for this channel so I can have my views. Hopefully I can have a loyal subscriber or maybe you can be my friends and we can make a community of ordinary people. Third one, I'm not really the type of person who is outrageous, and I'm not Atta Halilintar, or I'm not Ria Ricis, so that's definitely it. I'm just a chill kind of person. Well, but when I talk about something that I really, really, really passionate about, I can't stop. I just can't stop. I can continue talking about it and deeply about it. So yeah, I'm just looking for someone who has the same sort of type character like me. I don't know, maybe I'm just a human, I'm not a character. The third one, I'm not really rich. Define rich, but I don't do travel very often. I might say I only travel once a year, and especially in this pandemic, I didn't really go overseas. So that's definitely, I cannot be a travel vlogger. And where was I? Fourth one. And I also don't really have that special talent. Like, I cannot sing very well, I cannot make music, but I just really love photography, and again, I love videography. And my life is just kind of simple. I mean, I don't really do an OOTD stuff. I'm not into makeup also. I just wear whatever that is. So I'm not really passionate into the makeup. I love art, of course. Again, I said it, I love art. After a long search, I finally found some content creators that really inspired me. There are plenty of them, actually really big YouTuber. Like, they don't really have high numbers of subscribers, but I just love their work. For example, a couple months ago, I found out Natalie Lin, and it's Brett Jard. Like, she is the most genuine, I could say, person on the YouTube industry, I guess. Like, I really adore her movies, and it is good that there are some people who's really aspiring to be a filmmaker. At the same time, it's not really a big YouTuber. Yeah, I just really inspired by them. And also the Valspire family, Aiden, who owns the channel. Like, I really love watching his random stuff. Some of the content are fabricated, or we might say it's scripted, but it's really good script, you know, and it captures his everyday life. So yeah, I was inspired by him. There are a lot of people like Nathaniel Drew and Mattia Fea. The concept of the channel is about minimalism and essentialism, which I really into it. I was really into the essentialism, because I'm not saying I'm not materialistic, but I was shifting my way of life into essentialism. So yeah, I've learned a lot from their channel. And for the photography stuff, I love Jessica Kubaisi and Matthew Hapuja. Sorry if I pronounce it wrong. The contents are great, the editing was good, like it was clear, and yeah, I adore them so much. And also Kuto Tafika, I forgot her name, but she is also my inspiration for making this channel. And Obaid Fox, like, check out his channel, because he's only like 13 years old, I guess, and he's from Saudi Arabia, but he's British. The content, the vlog are really great. Like, when you watch it, it's like you are watching the movie. Like, it's a top-notch level of editing, and I'm here trying hard to learn how to edit transition like him. Like, it was so awesome. But anyway, why I mention all of this YouTuber or this content creator, because lately I've been trying to find my voice. trying to find my sound, because as Korea Ryomit said, one of my favorite YouTuber, we have to find our content. Like, if you want to make a channel, if your channel wants to be successful, we have to find the right content, not just random cinematic vlog. On the other hand, I didn't have a content and I just love capturing the moment. I'm searching and I found those inspiration, and what I've learned and what I've seen from those channel was they are just being genuine and they stick to what they love, which is making movies, making content. So it's either interview content or vlogging or tips. They're just really passionate into it and they're just stick to the route. After I've watched several content creator, I think I finally found my voice again. It's not about growing up the numbers. Of course, it will be awesome if I can grow the numbers, like I can create a community, a subscriber, also I can have an extra cash. It will be awesome, but the thing is, why I make this channel is because I want to preserve my memories, my life, and also I want to share with you guys, hopefully entertain you with the cinematic vlog kind of type that was not really having heavy topic, and also maybe my interview vlog, and you can find it up there, which is in Indonesian, of course, can inspire all of the viewers. And yeah, because I really love talking to people, like I love digging their stories, like how they made it here or the struggle. Like, I really love the real people, because sometimes I feel like we all live in a movies and all the people I met are the characters. So I just love listening to each characters that I met in my real life. So yeah, that's why I really, really, really love interviewing people and preserving the memories, and also making photography, making artsy stuff. It is kind of random, but I really think for the YouTube algorithm, because if I don't found out those channels, and also Is Harris, I really, really love Is Harris channel. You should also check her out, because the grading are crisp and the content are clear, and yeah, it's the content is not random like my vlog, but it's just on point. So yeah, you should check her out. Oh, one more thing, you should also check Kelly Stamps, because
she is boringly funny
in my words, because yeah, anyway, I thank you, the YouTube algorithm, or the ones who's behind the YouTube universe, because I found out those channels and they have all one thing in common. They talk about the things that they love, and that's just inspired me. And I love editing, and I will edit anything or make any content or talking about movies or food review or anything. So yeah, thank you for listening to my random chat. I hope you are entertained. Don't forget to click and subscribe, because I need that extra cash. Thank you, bye. Hope you have a wonderful day. I'm not saying that I'm real material. I'm not real.